create a new document. Open the image that you're going to use as a base to draw your shape. Copy and paste it in the new document. I'm using the pen tool to trace the left side of the bottle. Take your time and, if necessary, correct the path with the correct selection tool as you go along. Draw the bottle from a front view. I'm drawing a curve to reproduce the concave bottle bottom. Down the center of the bottle. Repeat these steps to draw the bottle top. Select the bottle shape and go to color box, set the fill to white and the stroke to none. Go to Effect 3D Revolve to open the 3D Revolve window. Then go to the Revolve section and change from left edge to right edge. As you can see from the 3D simulation of my bottle, the top is flat. It's missing the opening. I'm just going to fix the top part of the bottle opening because the rest of it will not be visible. I'm using the pen tool to draw a new shape. When you are finished, make sure this new shape is above the bottle shape. To make sure, right-click, select Arrange, bring to front. Select both shapes, go to the Pathfinder panel, and select minus front. Position you like and click OK. Select the cap shape. Go to Effect 3D Revolve, enter your position, and add a little bit of perspective. Isometric and perspective projection. Go to Appearance panel, double click on 3D Revolve. Here we can edit effects that have already been applied instead of going to the effects window and reapplying the same effect. For example, if you want to modify the bottle shape after you've applied the 3D effect, go to Appearance panel, click on the eye icon next to 3D Revolve to disable this effect's visibility. Now you can edit your path. When you are satisfied, go back to the Appearance panel, click on the eye icon again to activate the effect visibility. The cap I drew is different from the cap in the photo. Let's try to make it similar. Select the star tool and enter the following parameters. Select the direct selection tool, and after you select one of the points of the outside radius, hold shift to select all the others. Once you've selected all the points, slightly round the corners. Now repeat this step with the star's second radius. Once you've got all the points, round the corners a little wider than the first radius. Select the star shape. This time, we're going to Effect 3D Extrude and Bevel. Give the same parameters as the cap. The 3D effect visibility. Make a copy of these two shapes. We are going to use them in the next video. So far, we have used both 3D revolve and 3D extrude and bevel. Select the two shapes that form the cap. Go to Object, Expand Appearance. Now I'm going to make all the adjustments to unite these shapes. Stay tuned for part 2.